There are five key issues involved in diabetic foot complications. Self-care knowledge about the feet is the sheet anchor. Sensation of the feet is the most important primary cause for development of foot ulceration. Circulation to the foot compromises circulation, adds further injury. Structural abnormalities and deformities of the foot, formation of ulcers. So let us look at the dip. We have already seen the sensation and how to test the sensation, the contribution of insensate feet. We will now look at the deformities and then we will look at the circulatory aspects. We will go through some of the important deformities that can occur in diabetic feet. The common ones are the cones. Look here on the second toe, the dorsal aspect, you see a raised conical horny induration and thickening of the skin caused by friction or pressure. Hard cones may develop on the tops or tips of the toes, and soft cones develop between the toes. And in this drawing, you can see the calluses. Callus formation is a horny layer of skin caused by pressure or friction. It may spread across the ball of the foot or along the outer edge of the heel or the big toe. A callus may develop a central core or plug of tissue where the pressure is the greatest. Some more foot deformities, the deformities of the toes. Mallet toe, the mallet toe here, you see the joint nearest to the tip of the toe, the terminal interphalangeal joint, is bent. In hammer toe, the middle joint is bent. In the claw toe, the middle joint is bent and the metatarsophalangeal joint is extended. The joint at the base of the toe is bent up and the middle joint is bent down. So, this is mallet toe, terminal joint flexing, hammer toe, middle joint flexing, claw toe, middle joint flexing with extension at the metatarsophalangeal joint. So, these are the three types of common abnormalities apart from the two other abnormalities which we have seen in the previous slide. The other deformities are hallux valgus, mild to moderate. You can see the valgus deformity of the hallux. A small bump, or sometimes called a bunion, forms when the big toe turns inward towards the second toe. The joint at the base of the big toe is pushed to the side, this joint. If the hallux valgus is severe, if the hallux valgus is severe, the angulation of the big toe is marked, forming a large bunion. The big toe may move under the second toe. The big toe may move and the second toe may override the big toe. What is Charcot foot? This is the normal foot and this is a Charcot foot. The Charcot foot is a pes planus. There is bone and joint destruction and it has got three phases. An acute phase of onset with bony destruction, second phase, and the third phase of stabilization. In the acute phase, the foot is warm and swollen, 2 degrees Fahrenheit more than the other foot. 30% of these patients suffer pain. There is no history of trauma. Without any trauma, the foot is swollen, warm and tender and painful. The differential diagnosis, obviously cellulitis of foot. There is no evidence of ulceration or infection. So, in such cases, immobilization is essential to minimize the bony destruction until the foot temperature returns to normal or at least within 2 degrees Fahrenheit of the other foot. Then what happens is there will be bony destruction will set in, there will be rocker bottom with the plus pavis, and then that leads to pressure and predisposes to ulceration at the high pressure point. So, that is the, these are the various features of Charcot foot.